Of this unit, and we are going to talk about elimination. And so I'm just going to review what we did in the last lesson. So there's three types of answers when you use solve system equations. So see if you can fill those in. Okay, so we have independent, that's our model one, and this is not interval notation. This is just like a plain Jane coordinate point. So they meet here at the point like 1, 2. Inconsistent, your answer is not going to make sense, and that means that they're parallel. When it's dependent, your answer is going to make sense, but you're not going to have a variable, and it's going to be the same line. On this answer, U part of your answer is going to be the equation of that line, so we're going to see that today. So what elimination says is that we're going to eliminate one of the variables and combine them. So like, for instance, I might multiply this by 2 and combine it with this top equation. So when I combine this, notice that these are going to cancel out. So I'm left with 10, and you also see that you're adding these together. So 10x equals 10. So x equals 1. So these are really nice and neat to get to one of them, but you always have to plug it back in to get to your other one. So it doesn't matter. I'll do this one. I don't want to feel the negative. So 4 times 1 plus 2y equals 6. So I'm going to subtract 4 on both sides. 2 plus 2 equals 1. So our coordinate is going to be like this up here. It's going to be 1, 1. Okay, so this one is going to get a little bit yuckier. I'm going to tell you that your answer is going to be a Duffy fraction. So let me get you started off here. It doesn't matter which x or y you want to solve for. So I'm going to maybe do this times, I don't know, 3, and this times negative 4, and I'm going to eliminate the x. So go ahead and try that, and let's see. So for y, you should have ended up with 5 over 13. So you can do one of two things. You can definitely plug y in here and solve for x. The only bad thing is that it is a yucky fraction. I don't like doing that. So what I'll do is I'll just kind of start over and eliminate my y's this time. So the first one will focus on my x. I'm getting those canceled out. Now I'm going to focus my y. So I'm going to multiply this times 5 and this times 2. So go ahead and try that. So when you do that, you get x equals 17 over 13, so your final answer should look like this. Make sure you take it all the way. This is not considered your answer. This is your answer. Okay, so go ahead and do these next two. I don't know why this graph is here. And I want you to, change my mind on this, I want you to force yourself to do elimination. So go ahead and try these two and see. Okay, so I'll stop here. So once I did this, I ended up with an answer that does not make sense. So I'm going to go up here, and this is what that is telling me, that it's going to be two parallel lines. So my answer is going to be no solution, and just know that you have those parallel lines. Okay, so go ahead and do this again. Try to focus on elimination when you're doing this. Okay, so I reworked this. So it was 2x plus y equals 3. And then I multiplied it by negative 2. And I noticed that everything crosses out. So it's okay. Like, this makes sense, but I don't have any variables. So in this case, this is where it's like dependent, so it's like the same, it's like two lines on top of each other. So in this case, we have to write an equation of a line. So the first thing I'm going to say is infinitely many solutions Okay, so that's part of my answer. The other answer is we're going to use set builder notation. So x, y such that, and then we are going to put the equation of Okay, so let's do some. So xy such that, and then you try to get the simplified version. So see, this is the same thing as this one, just multiplied by 2. So I'm going to grab the 2x plus y equals 3. And so you are going to take this and that as part of your answer. Okay, we have two word problems here, and this one we have had multiple times, and so we're just going to revisit that again. And but this time I want you to think about writing it in a way that you could use elimination. So go ahead, I'm going to give you a few seconds to figure that out, so push pause and see if you can do that. Okay, so these should be the first, or the two equations that you came up with. So we have some number of gallons plus 90 equals some number of gallons added together. We also, we have the 5% times the number of gallons, and we know that there are 90 gallons of 1%. So that is going to be, that's a 0.9 there, and then it's going to equal 2% of this other value that we don't know yet. So personally, I don't like dealing with all these fractions. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move the decimal place over 2 spots on all of these so it looks nicer. So it's going to be like 5x plus 90 equals 2y. And I can wrap my mind around that a little bit better. I also don't like that this is in like the y's over there. So if I wanted to use substitution, I could. You can totally do that on those. But I'm just going to change this to x minus y equals negative 90. So, and then this one, I never think about this, this would be the same way. So 5x minus 2y equals negative 90. Okay, so I have this and I have this. I think what I might do is just multiply everything up here by negative 5. So this is a change. And this equals. Okay, so these cancel. I get 7y. Oops, sorry, not 7y, 3y equals 360. And so it says how many gallons of 5% milk. So I found this y, but I haven't found this x yet. So I'm gonna plus 90 equals 120. So x is 30. So to answer the question, it's gonna be 30 gallons of 5%. Okay, and then finally, this is a distance equals rate times time problem. And so we have like one way that's working against the wind, going from Fargo to Bismarck. But then going the other way, the wind is working in our favor. So if like the distance, that's going to be the same for each change. So it's 180. But my rate is going to change. So I have the rate, and then the wind is working against me. So I'm going to say R minus W here. And up here, I get a little boost for the wind coming back home, so I'm going to say R plus W. The time for the first way is going to be 2 hours. And then coming back is be careful because it's 1 hour, 12 minutes. So this ends up being, if I take 12 divided by 6, 0.2. So that ends up being 1.2, so just be careful about that. Okay, so I'm going to clean out both of these and just see what happens. Don't force yourself on this one especially. Just use whatever method works best for you. So 2R minus 2W equals 180. That's this one. And this one is 1.2R. Plus 1.2W equals 180. And then go ahead and solve it however you want to solve it. Personally, I think what I'm going to do is solve for R here. So I'll divide everything by 2 and then just move that w over. So once I have that, I'm going to take this and plug it in right there. So I guess I'm using substitution. Right, 1.2 times 9 plus w plus 1.2w is 1.8. Go ahead and see if you can solve for w. Okay, so this is my answer. This is on my work here, and it ended up getting that the wind speed is 30 miles per hour. So I also need to figure out, it says, what is the speed in still air, and then how fast is the wind blowing? So the wind's blowing 30 miles per hour. So I think the easiest thing is to come back here, that r is 90 plus w, and so my rate is going to be 100.